Hi, I'm Kevin Muenks with the Missouri Department of Conservation. Spicebush is a native shrub to Missouri and has become a popular landscaping plant for its eye-catching early blooming blossoms, beautiful fall foliage, and bright red berries that are edible to humans and numerous species of birds.
Spicebush is a broad, multi-stemmed shrub found in forest understories. The bark is smooth with prominent lenticels or small raised bumps on the woody stems. In early spring, before the plant's leaves emerge, clusters of 3 to 6 fragrant flowers appear close along the stems. Male and female flowers grow on separate plants, with only the female plants producing fruit. The leaves are 2 to 6 inches long and 1 to 3 inches wide, growing in an inverted egg shape from the plant. Often there are 2 leaf sizes, with smaller leaves at the base of larger ones. They are aromatic when crushed, and the stems smell spicy as well. In autumn, the leaves turn brilliant yellow, making the shrubs easy to spot under the forest canopy. The shrubs are the host plant for the spicebush swallowtail butterfly that lays single eggs on the leaves, which their caterpillars will consume after hatching. To avoid predators when not feeding, the caterpillars will fold the leaf margins over to form a silk-lined shelter where they can hide.
The fruits ripen and turn red in early autumn. Waiting until later in the season to harvest them will allow you to see them better.
The fruits grow solitary or in small clusters on short stalks and contain a single seed. Harvesting them is easy. Just grab a small container, and once you locate some female plants with ripe fruits, simply pick them from the branches. Be sure to leave some behind for birds to forage. After harvesting, they can be sun-dried or placed in a dehydrator with the seeds intact. Once dried, the fruits can be stored in a freezer for later use or ground using a coffee grinder. Dried whole fruits can be used instead of cloves, and the ground powder used in recipes calling for allspice. If you would like to cultivate your own shrubs, the seeds from the fruits can be planted after collecting them. Simply extract the seed from the fleshy part of the berry and be sure to keep it moist. Then plant them directly in the ground, burying them about 1/4 inch deep. You can also plant the seeds in pots, leaving them outdoors to overwinter. The shrubs will sprout in the spring, and after developing a strong root system, they can be transplanted to the ground. The shrubs will thrive in shady or partly shady spots, but will also grow in full sun.
I hope you get the chance to enjoy our native spicebush, whether it's growing in the wild or even in your own backyard. If you would like more information, you can go to our website at mdc.mo.gov. Thanks for watching.